You hurt people, you go down.
You ever prosecute a company as big as Purdue Pharma?
All of human behavior is essentially comprised of two things. Run from pain, run toward pleasure. Pain, pleasure, pain, pleasure. If we place ourselves right there between pain and pleasure, we will never have to worry about money again.
Pain is no longer something we have to tolerate. We have an answer.
How can something legally prescribed be killing so many people?
Tell me what words you associate with oxycodone.
Oxy what?
Oxycoffins.
Excuse me?
Don't put that in the notes.
We are under investigation.
How you doing? My name is Antonio. My page is Unapologetically Black. I want us to understand who I am. I am a separatist. And the reason why I'm a separatist is because I believe Europeans is at the core of the main problems within the Black community. Europeans are responsible for the drug epidemic. However, Blacks suffer the consequences of Europeans' actions because they fail to hold white people accountable for their actions. America's drug epidemic was created and produced by Europeans. White Americans are the biggest drug dealers ever known in the history of this world.
Could you tell me everything you know about Oxycontin?
You like horror movies?
Maybe the bad, bad things.
You will be convincing doctors to take pain seriously.
Oxycontin is the one to start with and the one to stay with. The more you prescribe, the more you'll help.
It is now the number one opioid in the country.
This drug is...
I did a video January 30th, 2022 called White America, Do You Have a Reflection? The fact is, America opiate epidemic is your fault, part one. What we have to understand is that Johnson & Johnson was the main opiate producer in the world. Johnson & Johnson connected with Purdue Pharma, which was the main pharmaco-producing company in the country. They agreed to come together to promote and widespread sell opiates. What they did was bribe doctors to prescribe opiates to its patients to hook them opiate patients, to hook those people on opiates. Once they drained your insurance of all its wealth, they kicked you off the insurance and left you to buy street drugs. My other video is really in depth about how this process went. So I ask that you go and check that video out.
Permeating every part of our community.
You're the cutest little Oxycontin kitten we've seen in a minute.
If it's working,
which it is,
we can increase the dose.
Let's kick you up to 40 milligrams.
It doesn't just kill people. It destroys the families and friends.
You're a drug dealer with a ponytail.
You bought that car with the death of a 16-year-old girl.
They are doing the exact same thing as every crack dealer in America, except they are getting rewarded for it.
He is in pain. He is addicted to pills, and it's your fault.
They know they are killing people. Richard Sackler.
Hello.
You did a good job making all that money, sir.
Thank you.
We have to understand what Europeans do is reflectionism. Why they attacked us for the use of marijuana in the Black community, calling it the gateway drug, you see the Oxycontins and pharmaceutical pills are the real gateway drugs to heavy drug use. And this has always been the case, and Europeans knew this, but it's easier to throw the blame on Black people, and Black people would accept the blame and fought their own for that exact, for that. Allow them to incarcerate us, blame us as the mean of the reason for this drug epidemic in America, when it's really always been Europeans.
And high overdose rates.
I mean, if you look at it, 4 of 5
injectable drug users started getting opioids, whether it be OxyContin, prescription or non-prescription pill taking. So there is a direct correlation between the two.
Annually, more than 214 million prescriptions for opioid pain have been given out, with more than 11 million people abusing their medication. But how did this problem get so catastrophic?
This footage is from the previous video I did, and it is explained to my people that these white people not only created the epidemic, the drug epidemic, but they also was able to profit off of it through the stock market. Even when you look at the penalties that apply to them, they do not neglect the profits that they have benefited from all of the destruction they had created with their product. White people fail to hold white people accountable for their actions, and this is why they are going through such a shock with Donald Trump being held accountable, because they've never seen white elites held accountable for their actions, regardless how negative or harmful those actions have been upon the community. They only seen successful or top elite whites be held accountable when they mistreat or rob or get over on other top white elites.
Johnson & Johnson's quiet domination of the opioid market. Explain how key Johnson & Johnson was and how this market and the epidemic developed simultaneously. How did they do it?
Sure. So the company's role was really multi-pronged. So on the one hand, they had their own opioid products that they were selling and they were marketing, and they had a whole sales force of folks who were going to doctors and encouraging doctors to prescribe those medications. But also, and this is something that I think that most people don't know about Johnson & Johnson, Johnson & Johnson had two subsidiaries that were responsible for manufacturing the majority of active ingredients in opioids that were marketed and sold in the United States, not just Johnson & Johnson opioids, but all sorts of opioids. So the way that they did this was back in the 90s, they had developed this high thebaine poppy. Thebaine is a type of opioid that's used in a lot of painkillers. And back in the 90s, they were able to connect with what is now Purdue Pharma to basically say, look, we have all these poppies. We have this active ingredient. We can help you to make this opioid painkiller, and we can supply as much of it as you want. And
let's be clear. American publicly traded company Johnson & Johnson enriched opiate to make it more addictive, contacted America's biggest volume and psychotropic drug seller to supply them with opiate, as well as various other companies, and other publicly traded U.S. companies also produced enriched opium. All right, since you watched the full video, I'll place a link in the description to the full video explaining how Europeans are responsible for America's drug epidemic and why building the wall would be nothing but keeping drugs in, not out. And I want us to understand how not holding Europeans accountable for their actions are leading to negative consequences for our entire community. This is why I am a separatist.
Richard Sackler.
Hello.
You did a good job making all that money, sir.
Thank you.
If you don't get out of my way, I'll run you over with my car and crush your skull.
Then you'll give me OxyContin to make it right.